Social Security retirement benefits have many important facets that need to be understood before making your retirement plan. One of these features is spousal benefits. Maria Recto, Vice President Wealth Advisor from Zions Wealth Advisors, is here to give us some guidance on how spousal benefits work and point out a couple of aspects you may want to think about when considering how it will affect your bottom line. Maria, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
Let's begin by talking about spousal benefits. What exactly are they?
So spousal benefit is, it actually refers to the monthly income that a spouse or a former spouse of a disabled or retired worker can get.
So let's just talk about the correlation between a spouse that's working, let's say their whole life, and maybe a wife that is in and out of the workforce. How does that correlate?
So you actually don't have to work under Social Security in order to qualify for those retirement benefits. Mm-hmm. There's two criteria that you'll have to meet. First, you have to at least be 62 years old. Then the second is you have a spouse or a former spouse that is either receiving or is qualified to receive retirement or disability benefits.
So what is considered full retirement age? I know you just mentioned 62, mm-hmm. But that's when you can start taking it. So what is considered the full retirement age?
So the year that you were born actually determines what your NRA is, or the normal mm-hmm. retirement age, as far as the Social Security calculation benefits is concerned. So it ranges anywhere from 65 to 67.
So what about somebody that's taking care of a disabled child? I know that that's part of it, that you can receive benefits from that, from a spouse.
Yes, so you don't have to hit any age at all, as long mm-hmm. as you are taking care of a child, even if they're disabled or not, or age 16 and younger. So there's, again, some other areas in there that you could start collecting spousal benefits without hitting that age requirement.
So let's say that I have a husband that is older than I am, and I reach age 62 and I start collecting my benefits, and then he waits till his full retirement age. Can I take that step up to get half of his retirement, or am I kind of locked in where I started at 62? Okay.
That's a great question, and I think an illustration would probably be easier to show that. Mm-hmm. So let's say we have a couple, married couple, John who's age 66, and say Mary who's age 62, right? In this situation, Mary has the option to wait to collect her Social Security at that point. So if John, because he worked most out of the home, and will be scheduled to collect $2,000 a month, and Mary was scheduled to collect only $600 because she had been raising the children in and out of the workforce, right? So if she decides to collect Social Security at age 66, she will get not only her $600, but she will get a bump up of an additional $400, which is equal to half of what John's monthly benefit will be. Mm-hmm. However, if Mary decides to collect at age 62, just like in your example, she will still get the $400 of a spousal benefit, but her $600 will be reduced permanently to about 25%. So instead of $600, she will get $450.
So really what you're saying, it's important to just wait till the full retirement age, you know, if you can afford it, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, if another mm-hmm. strategy in there is, in that situation, if John decides, you know, we don't really need the monthly benefit, and I could go ahead and wait, he could suspend right. collecting that until age 70, and at that time, he will actually get a bump into his monthly benefit to about $2,640. Right. And when he passes away, and Mary's still living, then Mary will actually receive the same 100% of what John was receiving. So again, another benefit for them.
Maria, thank you so much for joining us. A lot of great information here. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
To see more videos like this, subscribe to the Zions Direct YouTube channel.